My goal on defense is not to score. It's to stop him from scoring, right? Also, my goal on defense is not to get away from him. Many of you guys, I watch you wrestle. You think defense is don't touch me, get away from me. I back up. You know, our goal on defense is to break his position, to get him out of his stance. If I get him out of his stance, I can make him weaker. If I make him weaker, I can get him extended. If I get him extended, I can make him not score. Okay? That's the principle. We have three lines of defense. Has anybody talked about those yet? Yes. What's our first line of defense? Head. Okay. Can anybody give examples of that? No. Okay. An example of my head's line of defense. Mario gets an underhook on me. All right. Mario's got an underhook. He's in a strong offensive position. Right? From here, it'd be easy for him to attack this leg. Look, he's beating my arm by being inside. He's beating my head by being lower. You know, he can just throw this up here and go to a single leg. So one example of our head's line of defense is I can do this. Right? I get head position. My head gets lower than his, right? I'm blocking him off here, I'm making it difficult. So even though he may be beating my arm, all right, it's tough for him to attack because my head is in the way. All right, that's one way we kind of fight head position. Two, let's say he shoots. As Mario shoots here, he shoots, I lower my level, I down block, my head got in the way. So I didn't let him get it underneath me, okay? I use my head there to block him off. All right, that's my head as a line of defense. Then as he comes up, I can take a counter attack. Super important as you go further using this as a line of defense. Why? Because the counterattack opportunities are extremely important. If you watch the World Team Trials, it was amazing how many counterattacks were used. I mean, for instance, I mean the biggest one I saw was if you watch Jordan Burroughs versus Dave, and then you watch Dave versus Taylor, it seemed like almost every score was a counterattack opportunity. Right? Second line of defense are what? Hands. Alright, hands in the line of defense. That could be this. Mario shoots. As he shoots, I down block. Now look, my arm got in the way. So look, Mario beat my head. His head is lower than my head. You guys see that, right? So he got underneath me, but my arm was in the way. He didn't do something. He failed in some way to beat this arm. He didn't get inside, he didn't pull it, he didn't post it, he didn't do something to make me move this arm, and my arm was in the way of my leg, so I downed, okay? Those are my first two line of defense. The reality is this. You wrestle, stud. You wrestle a guy that really knows what he's doing. The hardest part is actually beating those two lines of defense. When you wrestle the guy that's won the multiple state titles, things like that, the hardest thing is getting to his legs. And that's this and this, okay? Your hand fighting skills. Can you get him out of position enough to even get there? All right, then we get there. Now it's our third line of defense. Now it's our hips. And this is where we're gonna spend most of this session. Using this as a line of defense. Now, Mario's got a head inside single, now look. His head is lower than my head. His hands are inside my hands. Now it's time for me to beat his position. You guys, high schoolers, you think it's about getting away from him, all right? For us here, it's about beating his position. I want to get him on the mat, his head down, compact him, get him out of his stance. My right hand is going to go to the top of his head. My left hand is going to go to a deep tight waist. What I'm going to do is I'm going to shove his head down. The principle is this. If I can get his head in the mat, and I can get his head somewhere between my hips and my chest here, I'm going to control his head. There's no way he's going to be able to score. My right hand shoves his head down. My left hand is going to go to a deep tight waist. From here, my feet go back, my hips come in, I square up and sprawl. Now look, he's feeling one hip right now. I've sprawled, I really haven't squared up yet. He's feeling one hip and he's feeling my left hip. Notice, my left hip's on him, but my right hip is not. He needs to feel the weight of both hips. He's gonna do that by me bringing my right hip in. Not backing up like this, where my butt comes up in the air, but bring my right hip in. I'm gonna do that by stepping up with my right foot. As I step up with my right foot, I'm gonna windshield wiper my left foot. My left foot's gonna windshield wiper on my left knee here. I'm gonna bring my right hip into this position. Now, my right hand, as soon as I get his head down, I'm gonna be attacking his hamstring, his ankle, or his foot. I like his foot a lot if I can get it, and I can extend his knee. This also, all right, limits his motion or blocks his placement. From here, I don't back up, like I said, when it comes to my knees. But I drive in and down. I'm driving into my opponent. I'm going in and out. I'm crushing him with my hips. Let's do it again. He's on a head inside single. Right hand goes on top of the head. Notice I'm not just shoving with my arm. My whole body shoves his head down. As I shove his head down with my body, I'm starting to get a bend over. Now my feet go back. My hips can come in here, and I'm going to drive. As I drive and do this, I'm pulling my elbow back in my stance. I'm pulling the tight waist. I'm pulling the hamstring, and I'm driving into Martin. I'm trying to crush his position. His left foot, we just did a heavy side single comeback, okay? His left foot is his trail leg. It does all his motion. Think about it. It steps forward on the cutback. It swings behind on chasing the ankle, right? So if I control this leg here, I can stop his movement. I also give myself something to pull my hips in, so it does a dual purpose, and it's really important. I want to attack his left leg. Again, right hand shoves head down. Left hand, feet tight waist. Feet go back, hips come in. Notice how I go in, square up, it's falling. Right hand to the hamstring from here. I'm going to drop. I drive my hips in the neck. This stays for a minute. One, you guys focus on speed. You'll do a great sprawl. You do a good job. And then you're so focused about spinning around the guy that you let all your weight come to your knees and you run around real quick. And you know what? You relieve the pressure. You relieve the pressure. His head comes up. He does stuff like split the middle. He finds a way to chase it or come back. Okay? I don't want that. Keep pressure on him the whole time. Keep him underneath you. All right? Also, you'll keep your right hand on the head too long. As soon as my body can cover his head, so once I get to about like right here, now I can attack. And I can use this to drop. All right, my hips in. Notice, my hips are in and down. My butt is down. It's not weight like this. If my weight's on my knees, my butt's up in the air, there's different weights on me, but my knees, not on him. I want him to feel my weight, to feel my pressure by driving. You guys with me? Let's do it. One, two, three.